Well, good evening, everyone, and welcome to the 11th online chamber concert from Virtual Music Land. It's been a hugely busy and exciting week in Virtual Music Land, and we've been recording songs from the shows, which is the theme of tonight's concert. I've really enjoyed playing the piano. I know Mr. O'Holaby and Mr. Barber have, and I hope you all agree that this bumper concert has an unbelievable display of talent in it. So, the one brilliant thing for you all is that I am not going to do the introductions tonight, which I'm sure you're delighted to hear. I'm going to leave that in the very capable hands of Nia Richards and Theo Harris in the upper sixth. Both Nia and Theo were the driving force behind this evening, and as you all know, are stalwarts of Brentwood School Music Department, the Performing Arts Faculty, and particularly the world of musical theatre, which they both love. So, without any further ado, Nia and Theo, take it away.
Good evening, everyone, and welcome to tonight's Songs from the Shows concert held here in Virtual Music Land.
We are privileged to be hosting this concert because, as we all know, we love being the centre of attention. My name is Nia Richards.
And my name is Theo Harris, and whilst this wasn't how we expected to be holding this year's Songs from the Shows, we have the honour to be guiding you through tonight's virtual concert.
So if you know us, which you should, you'll know that we love some musical theatre singing, and here to kickstart this concert are two amazingly talented upper sixth singers.
Here are Hannah Walker and Amy Mayhew singing For Good from the Broadway classic Wicked.
Take it away, girls.
Said that people come into our lives for a reason, bringing something we must learn. We are led to those who help us most grow if we let them, and we help them in return. Well, I don't know if I believe that's true, but I know I'm who I am today because I knew you. Like a comet pulled from orbit as it passes a sun, like a stream that meets a boulder halfway through the wood. Who can say if I've been changed for the better? But because I knew changed for good.
It well may be that we will never meet again in this lifetime. So let me say before we part, so much of me is made from what I learned from you. You'll be with me like a handprint on my heart, and now whatever way our stories end, I know you have rewritten mine by being my friend. Like a ship blown from its mooring by a wind off the sea, like a sea dropped by a sky bird in a distant world.
Because I knew you,
I have been changed for good. And just to clear the air, I ask forgiveness for the things I've done you blame me for.
But then I guess we know there's blame to share,
and none of it seems to matter anymore.
Been changed for the better. Because I knew you.
Because I knew you.
Because I knew you.
I have been changed. For good.
Thank you, Hannah and Amy, for that fantastic performance, one they'll be repeating for this year's prom concert, taking place on August 30th.
Next up, we have a bunch of talented lower school musicians singing songs from Beetlejuice, based on the 1988 film Beetlejuice, starring Michael Keaton, and Alan Menken's Beauty and Beast.
The Trevelyan siblings are here to bring some comedy with the song Say My Name from Beetlejuice, followed by Alex Lockyer in the third year, who has multi-tracked himself, playing the piano, cello, and singing If I Can't Love Her from Beauty and the Beast.
You could use a buddy. Don't you want a pal? Yes, I do. Yes, I do. Girl, the way I see it, your dad should be leaving and you should stick around and kill him.
What?
Nothing. So, Lydia, don't end yourself. Defend yourself. Daddy is the one you should make. Together we'll exterminate. Assassinate.
No.
We'll find a point to come with before anybody says my name. Go ahead and jump with that one. Stop it here. You got a solid plan B option. I can bring your daddy so much. All you gotta do is say my name. Go to say it three times in a row. Then you won't believe how far I'll go. I'm on the bench, but coach, just put me in the game. All you gotta do is say my name.
I don't know your name.
Well, I can't say it.
How about a game of charades?
Yes, let's play it.
Two words.
Right.
Second word.
Uh-huh.
Drink.
No.
Beverage.
No.
Wine.
No.
Juice.
Yes.
Okay, first word.
Okay.
Buck.
No.
Ants.
Close, but no.
Beetle.
Yes. Wow, I'm impressed. And all you gotta do is say my name three times. Three times in a row. It must be spoken on program. Ready?
Yeah.
Okay, go.
Beetlejuice.
Yes.
Beetlejuice.
Yes.
Beetlejuice.
Oh, this is gonna be so good!
Cause you're so smart. A stand-up role. I'll think about your opera. Let you know that I'm for my chances down below. Beetlejuice, Beetlejuice, Beetlejuice.
You are tougher than you look.
Just to make sure I know who I'm working with. Got any references?
Lydia, there you are. Are you alright?
Beat Barbara, my old pal.
You get away from her, Lydia. This is a dangerously unstable individual. Gilge is sexy. Gilge is smart. BJ is a graduate from Juilliard. He can't help. We found him on Yelp. Our troubles all landed on the day that we befriended him. Every word is the truth. Beetlejuice, Beetlejuice, Beetlejuice.
Any ghost can do that in less than one lesson.
Any ghost?
Pretty much, any ghost can do short.
Beetlejuice, what do I need you for?
Whoa, 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 whoa. Hold up, girl. I'm your pal this week, but I'm a demon straight from hell. I know I went a little hard on myself. We're BFFs forever. Ah!
Lydia, what? He was already dead. And you could have said, any ghost can do that possession stuff.
We don't need that demon, the two of us alone can wreck Dad's evening. Together we can make a grown-man weep. Guys got a dinner date to keep. Okay, so what's the plan? Teach Dad a lesson. He's gonna freak when we possess him. So he wants the perfect daughter. I'll leave that lamb to slaughter. Yeah, I got game. I'm gonna make him say my name.
Say my name.
I'm running.
sure that we were not that talented in the third year. I mean, you have an amazing singing teacher.
So next up, we have an incredibly sad song followed by an incredibly funny song. Nicole Fergus in the fifth year will be singing Still Hurting from Jason Robert Brown's The Last 5 Years.
Followed by Max Kiernan, who you may recognise as Thénardier from our production of Les Mis, who will be singing You'll Be Back from the Tony Award-winning musical Hamilton.
Still.
say, the price of my war's not a price that you're willing to pay. You cry with your tea, which you heard in the sea, when you see me go by. Why so sad? Remember we made an arrangement when you went away. Now you're making me mad. Remember, despite our estrangement, I'm your man. You'll be back, soon you'll see. You'll remember you belong to me. You'll be back, time will tell. You'll remember that I served you well. Oceans rise, empires fall. We have seen each other through it all. And when push comes to shove, I will send a fully armed battalion to remind you of my love. Da 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 da.
We really hope you're enjoying the show so far. It's so great to see our musicians thriving during these unprecedented times.
Yeah, we just wanted to take a moment quickly, just say thank you to Mr. Cooper and the entire performing arts faculty. You know, throughout the entirety of lockdown, they've continued to push us and make sure that we're still happy and making music.
Every week, Mr. Cooper puts on these concerts, as well as teaching during the weeks. And we have now discovered that it takes a lot more time, energy, and hard work to pull off than you might think. So thank you, sir, for keeping everyone's spirits high here in Virtual Musicland.
The next two performances will be from Upper Sixth student Emily O'Sullivan, who has recently been awarded a place at Mountview Academy of Theatre Arts, who will be singing Everything I Know from her favourite musical, In the Heights, written by Lin-Manuel Miranda.
Followed by the opening song from Miranda's most acclaimed musical, Hamilton, performed by a group of lower school singers, Sammy Lee, Janie Horton, Finley Hughes, Katie Hackett and Claire Hurst. Enjoy.
In this album, there's a picture of the ladies at Daniela's. You can tell it's from the 80s by the volume of their hair. There's your snobby, just a baby, 87, Halloween. If it happened on this block, abuela was there. every afternoon I came. She'd make sure I did my homework. She could barely write her name. But even so, she would stare at the paper and tell me, "Bueno, let's review. Why don't you tell me everything you know?" In this album, there's a picture of Abuela in Havana. She is holding a ragdoll, unsmiling, black and white. I wonder what she's thinking. Does she know that she'll be leaving for the city on a cold, dark night? And on the day they ran, did she dream of endless summer? Did her mother have a plan? Or did they just go? Did somebody sit her down and say, "Claudia, get ready to leave behind everything you know"? There's a picture from my high school graduation with a program mint condition and a star beside my name. There's a picture of my parents as I left for California. She saved everything we gave her, every little scrap of paper in our lives are in these boxes.
Does a wretched orphan, son of a bawd and a Scotsman, dropped in the middle of a forgotten spot in the Caribbean, improvident, impoverished, and squalor, grow up to be a hero and a scholar?
The $10 founding father without a father got a lot farther by working a lot harder, by being a lot smarter, by being a self-starter, by 14. They placed him in charge of a trading charter.
And every day, while slaves were being slaughtered and carted away across the waves, he struggled and kept his guard up. Inside, he was longing for something to be a part of. The brother was ready to beg, steal, borrow, or barter.
Then a hurricane came, and devastation reigned. A man saw his future drip, dripping down the drain. Put a pencil to his temple, connected it to his brain, and he wrote his first refrain, a testament to his pain.
Well, the word got around, they said, "This kid is insane, man." Took up a collection just to send it to the mainland. Get your education, don't forget from whence you came, and the world's gonna know your name. What's your name, man?
Alexander Hamilton. My name is Alexander Hamilton. There's a million things I haven't done. Just you wait, just you wait.
When he was 10, his father split, full of it, dead, written 2 years letters. Alex and his mother bedridden, half dead, sitting in their own sick, sent fit.
And Alex got better, read his mother, went quick.
Moved him with a cousin, a cousin committed suicide. Left him with nothing but ruined pride, something new. Side of boys saying,
"Alex, you got a friend for yourself."
Started retreating and reading.
for someone less than stick, he would have been dead or destitute without a cent of restitution. Started working, clerking for his late mother's landlord, trading sugar cane and rum and all the things he can't afford. Scanning for every book he can get his hands on, planning for the future, seeing there as he stands on the bow of a ship heading for a new land. In New York, you can be a new man.
In New York, you can just be a new man. In New York, you can just be a new man. In New
coming up from the bottom, his enemies destroyed. America forgotten.
We fought him.
Me,
I died for him.
Me, I trusted him.
Me, I loved him.
And me, I'm the damn fool that shot him.
There's a million things I haven't done. It's just you wait.
What's your name, man?
It's clear to see that this concert definitely has a soft spot for the musical Hamilton. Next up will be two pairs of siblings. Catherine and Sarah Pryor will be singing my favourite song from Mean Girls the musical, Apex Predator.
Followed by Cameron and Emily Davies singing City of Stars from the movie musical La La Land. Enjoy.
By the pink, she is not playing dolls, she is stalking the halls for the thrill of the kill. Every person in school is aware of her stare. When she tosses her hair, they go perfectly still. All their eyes say, don't attack me. Watch them sweat and pant and shake. Every food chain has its acme. Brigida, Georgie, steak. She's the queen of beasts. She can smell your fear in this biosphere. She's the apex predator, like a lioness with less fur. Do not mess with her. She's the apex.
At the watering hole, see the girls who are nice have to scatter like mice from a jungle cat. And though Janice is great, she does not have this power. People literally cower. Janice can't do that. See us mark our territory as I follow in her train. I was victim, I was Corey. Now I shake. In her
Half of this concert, lower sixth student Ishan Chopra will be singing the song Waving Through a Window, which is from the musical that's taken the West End by storm, Dear Evan Hansen.
In a previous clip, you would have seen us thanking both Mr. Cooper and the rest of the performing arts faculty, but it's also just as important for us to thank Ishan as well.
Yeah, the majority of these concerts, the big band, barbershop, girls' choir performances, they've all been edited by Ishan himself. It takes him hours to edit just one video. And he does it without complaint every single week for Mr. Cooper. And he also keeps up with all of his schoolwork.
Virtual Music Land would not be at the standard that it is without him. So thank you very much, Ishan.
Thank you, Ishan.
I've learned to slam on the brake before I even turn the key, before I make the mistake, before I lead with the worst of me. Give them no reason to spare, no slipping up if you slip away. So I've got nothing to share, no, I've got nothing to say. And step out, step out of the sun if you keep getting burned. Step out, step out of the sun, because you've learned. Outside, always looking in, will I ever be more than I've always been? Cause I'm tap, tap, tapping on the glass. I'm waving through a window. I try to speak, but nobody can hear. So I wait around for an answer to appear while I'm watching people. Sun does arise, but no one tells me where you
The first half of this virtual Songs from the Show's concert.
We'll be taking a 5-minute interval, so that's plenty of time for you to get some snacks and replenish your wine glass.
But make sure you do stay tuned in though, because there'll be more performances from some familiar faces. Welcome to the interval.
Here in virtual music land, there is actually not a real concept of time, so whilst it may be Friday evening for the rest of you, over here it's actually Wednesday morning, and so I have got a coffee instead of wine.
And I'm not 18 yet, so I have cereal, because we've been filming at 9:30 in the morning, and we have not had breakfast yet, so...
That's true, I haven't eaten anything today. So, Nia, what would you say is your favourite moment from your time here in performing arts at school?
Well... That's a lot, because I've been doing, we've both been doing it, what, since first year? I don't know. I will always remember just little things that I've done that is just embarrassing, and only me would think of doing something like that. Oh, actually, oh my God, I've just thought of a really funny moment that I had forgotten about. During Les Mis, I think it was like one of the middle nights, I think maybe like the Thursday or the Wednesday night. Mm-hmm. And during the epilogue, so when Valjean dies, and it's, so Neo was on the bed, and Elizabeth and Will were like next to him, and then Hannah comes out, and then I come out, we come out as ghosts, and when he's like actually dying, us three, Hannah, Neo and I, all sing together, and there's a bit where we like pull him off of the bed to like stand up and like as if he's like come to heaven. And I don't know what was wrong with the bed or what happened, but all you heard was this like thud. The bed had like broken, and Hannah and I are trying to like pull Neo up, because I'm not that strong, and like I don't think he was like standing himself up, so we were both there like trying to pull while singing like this really sad part of the song, and the bed had like folded in on itself. And I remember like I was like, don't laugh, like he's dead, like it's a really serious part of the show. That was funny. I remember that was brilliant.
Good memories from that. I think my favourite moment in this, like since I really started the school, was the Battle of the Big Bands 2019. Yeah. And I had auditioned to sing with the big band, and I was allowed to sing this song called I've Got You Under My Skin. And I didn't tell a single person in my family that I was going to be doing this. And so I had quite a lot coming, actually, because they always love to come to these sorts of events. And they were all sitting right at the back of the auditorium. And then I think it was like second or third to go on. And as soon as my name got called out, they were all like clamoring over, like to try and get like a good place to film me. Yeah. And quite frankly, I'm kind of impressed that I was able to keep that secret from them for that amount of time. And obviously everything that happened within Upper Six, so Les Mis, House Music, all of them, like that first term at Upper Six, like obviously I know it's ended in a bit of a weird way, but it was just probably the most perfect term I could have had, really, like before the virus came in. But yeah, that was definitely...
Memories from Barcelona.
Oh, Barcelona, yeah.
And my songs from the show's concert last year as well, I actually really liked, because one of my favourite ones was when the boys, we did the miscast bit, and then the older boys did Cell Block Tango, and Rob Pardington was Hunyak, and was like speaking Hungarian, but he wasn't, he was just like...
Oh.
British. And it was just the funniest. And like those rehearsals were the funniest thing. And Mr. Cooper just looked at all of them in such disbelief. He was like, oh, what am I putting on stage right now?
Hey, talking from a Songs from Shows concert, we're in one right now. Should we get on with the second?
Let's get on with the second act. We've got a lot more to come.
Fantastic.
And we are back.
To begin the second half, we have a debut performance from fourth form student Jemima Corcoran, who will be singing Maybe This Time from Cabaret, a song once made famous by Liza Minnelli.
This will be followed by a performance from our littlest member of the Performing Arts Department, Anna Romhani, who will be singing Wouldn't It Be Lovely from My Fair Lady.
This time I'll be lucky. Maybe this time he'll stay. Maybe this time, for the first time, love won't hurry away. He will hold me fast. Nobody loved me.
that was brilliant. Well done, Jemima. Okay, so next up we have Theo. We have a
what?
We have someone in our waiting room.
Who?
It's a Bond. Oh my god, where's your blazer? We need to get school ready.
God. Why didn't you let us know?
I don't know. How do I look? I look smart enough, right?
Fantastic. How do I look? Oh.
Brilliant. Okay.
Right.
I'm always in trouble. What have I done now?
Okay. Oh, God. Okay. Sir.
What's up?
Hi.
Hi, guys. Look, I'm really sorry to Zoom bomb me like this, but I just need to ask you for some help. Is that okay?
Yeah,
that's fine. That's fine.
I'm really worried about Mr. Cooper. I don't really know what to do. At first, I was just worried about his fashion sense. I mean, have you seen those jumpers that he's wearing? Have you seen them?
I have, unfortunately.
You know, but I was thinking, well, we could let that go. You know, he's not in school. It's okay. You know,
yeah.
No threat to anyone. You know, it's all right. But now, I think that he thinks Virtual Music Land is actually a real place. And I'm really worried he's not going to come back to school. I think we might have lost Mr. Cooper. And I don't know what we can do about it, but I was just thinking, you know, who could I talk to? And I just thought, I'll speak to Mia and Theo. Yeah, I can't even get my words out. I'm just so worried about him. You know, we need Mr. Cooper back in September, the great director of music. And I'm just worried we've lost him in Virtual Music Land.
If anyone has a dose of reality, I think it's us.
Yeah.
Would you mind speaking to him and just seeing if you can get him back to us?
Of course. No, don't worry. Get him back.
I really appreciate it because I don't know what else to do. You're my last hope. Is that okay?
That's fine. That's all good.
Please don't say that I've said anything to him. You know, and I hope you're not recording this because I don't want him to know that I'm really worried about him.
No, okay.
Yeah. Ooh, your secret's safe with us.
Right. I'm going to have to go, okay? So thanks very much, guys. Keep me posted, okay? See you later.
Okay.
Bye-bye.
Bye, sir. Thanks, sir.
He's right though, those jumpers are getting awful.
They are, aren't they? Okay. So who's up next?
Right, who's up next? The next two performances are from some very familiar faces here in Virtual Music Land. Hannah Walker will be singing I'd Give My Life For You from the musical Miss Saigon.
Followed by second year student Bessie Taggart, who'll be reprising her role as Little Red Riding Hood in Sondheim's Into the Woods with I Know Things Now.
Perfect night when the stars burn.
sorely misled. I should have heeded her advice, but he seemed so nice. And he showed me things, many beautiful things that I hadn't thought to explore. They were off my part, so I never had dared. I had been so careful, I never had cared. But he made me feel excited, well, excited and scared. When he said, come in, with that sickening grin, how would I know what was in store? Once his teeth were bare, then I really got scared. Well, excited and scared, but he drew me close and he swallowed me down, down a dark, slimy path where lie secrets that I never want to know. And when everything familiar seemed to disappear forever, at the end of the path was crowning once again. So we lay in the dark until someone set us free, brought into the light, and we're back at the start. Now I know things now, many valuable things that I hadn't known before. Do not put your faith in a cape and a hood. They will not protect you the way that they should. And take extra care with strangers. Even flowers have their dangers. And the scary is exciting. Nice is different than good. Now I know, don't be scared. Granny is right, just be prepared. Is it nice to know a lot? And a little bit not.
Next up, we have yet another song from one of our past musicals. Murray Pete, who you most likely will have seen with a guitar in his hand, will be singing Mr. Cellophane from the second longest running musical on Broadway and our school show here in 2017, Chicago.
This will then be followed by a once-in-a-lifetime performance, okay? After six students, Catherine Pryor, Ellen Fashion, and Elizabeth Moore, who you may have seen as Cosette in our production of Les Mis, are going to be singing a song from Hamilton called Schuyler Sisters.
Now, we really hope you enjoy this performance, especially as it demonstrates Ellen's rapping skills, which, as you probably know, are second to none.
If someone stood up in a crowd and raised their voice up way out loud, and waved their arms and shook their leg, you'd notice them. If someone in the movie show yelled fire in the second row, this whole place is a powder keg, you'd notice them. And even without clucking like a hen, everyone gets noticed now and then. Should be invisible, inconsequential me. Cellophane, Mr. Cellophane, should have been my name, Mr. Cellophane, 'cause you can see right through me, walk right by me. You know who.
deserve more than going downtown and slumming it with the poor. They put up in their carriages and gawk at the students in the commons just to watch them talk. Take Philip Schuyler, the man is loaded. Uh-oh, but little does he know that his daughters, Peggy, Angelica, Eliza, sneak into the city just to watch all the guys at...
Have a link to.
Yeah, I know, but I really like that song and that rap. We did it for a song, a dance in the dance show, and I just think I understand that Ellen's like a brilliant rapper and whatever, and she's Ellen, but I think I could. I wanna go up against her. I think I could rap better than her.
Nia.
Yeah.
I doubt it. Let's just put it that way.
Pardon?
Well. No offense, but it's so like you to think that you're better than someone else.
Excuse me, when have I said that? When have I ever said I'm better than someone else recently?
Don't you remember when we were doing Les Mis? You would constantly come up to me and be like, I reckon I can sing Stars better than you. And I was thinking, oh,
I mean, goodness sake. In a tricky way, maybe, but like realistically, I mean, I wasn't wrong, was I? Like, I could do that entire show one woman.
Nia. You're delusional.
Well, I don't think I am. And you know what, Theo? I will prove it to you once and for all. Sir, hit it.
Out in the darkness, a fugitive running. Shall yield till we come face to face, till we come face to face.
He knows his way in the dark. Mine is the way of the Lord. Those who follow the path of the righteous shall have their reward. And if you fall as a loss of a flame, the flames, the sword starts in your multitudes, scarce to be counted, filling the darkness with order and light. You are the sentinels, silent and sure, keeping watch in the night, keeping watch in the night. You know your place in the sky, you hold your course and your aim, and each in your season returns and returns, and is always the same. And if you fall as a lucifer fell, you fall in vain. For so it must be, for so it is written on the doorway to paradise, that those who falter and those who fall must pay the price.
I never said you couldn't sing it. I just think it's a bit of a cheap stunt to try and use one of my songs to try and make people think that you're better than me.
Fine, maybe you have a point, okay? It's your song, but I really, really would love to see you try and sing one of my songs better than me. And with all that emotion and, you know, that heartfelt acting, I would love to see you try.
Oh, one of your songs?
Yeah.
You mean like this one?
On my own, pretending he's beside me, all alone, I walk with him till morning. Without him, I feel his arms around me, and when I lose my way, I close my eyes and he has found me. In the rain, the pavement shines like silver. All the lights are misty in the river. In the darkness, the trees are full of starlight, and all I see is him and me forever and forever. And I know it's only in my mind that I'm talking to myself, to him. And although I know that he's blind, still I say there's a way for us. I love him, but when the night is over, he is gone. The river's just a river. Without him, the world around me changes. streets are full of strangers. I love him, but every day I'm learning that all my life I've only been pretending. Without me, his world will go on turning, a world that's full of happiness that I have never known. I love him. I love him. I love him. But only on my own.
Okay, fine. That was good. I'll give you that. The acting, in my opinion, is a bit over the top. I mean, do you really need to cry? I mean, but you make a point, okay?
Yeah, look, Nia, if I'm being honest, I don't want to play any more games. I think we should just call it even.
You're fine. You know what? You're right. I mean, we've known each other, what, like 10, 12 years now? And like,
yeah.
We've always shared the spotlight ever since, you know, Oliver back in year six, you know? To get along. That shouldn't stop now, you know?
Absolutely. I mean, you know, if I'm honest, your version of stars really, really moved me. I went from here to here. Moved.
You're just fine, but no, we all know no one can sing that song better than you. But honestly, your version of On My Own, I mean literal goosebumps. Like the emotion, the gut-wrenching feeling, it was just exuding like heartbreak and misery and that the crying and I was just blown away. Like I could never do anything as good as that. You know, it was just wow.
You're too kind. I mean, I really missed the show.
I know, me too. It was such a good time. I mean, we had that one scene. We were on stage for the same time when I was running away from you. I wish we could do it again. I wish we could just sing together as a cohort, you know, one last time. Like, that would be the best wish
the dream.
Grant me.
One day more, another day of exiled revelry, this never-ending road to enmity. My friends who've known me in my prime will surely come a second time, one day
more. I did not zoom until today. Now I can live when we are parted.
One day more.
With my teachers on the screen.
not a time to be a schoolboy. My life's over at 15.
Watch the runner bow, looking for some soap. Never be in doubt that we preserve some hope. One day very soon, barricades will fall. Students and survivors, and we will stand tall.
And so that's the end of our concert. We really, really hope you enjoyed it.
It was actually really fun to host this concert, but I think we're both ready to hand that responsibility back over to Mr. Cooper because I think we're a bit tired from those early morning Zoom calls with Sir. So
all that's left for us to say is stay healthy,
stay happy, but most importantly, stay safe.
Stay safe.